Hi there. We are going to do a project today. Move my phone out of the way and get a brush. I'm going to use my ZenZone brush. LEBEZON, handmade. And an SAA Kolinsky. Wet that Kolinsky real good. This is a size 6. The first thing I did, back up just a minute. I've had this beautiful little book for a while. Don't remember where I got it. But it's Cotti paper. And I really do enjoy it. The paper is a little off-white, and I sprayed some instant coffee. I keep it in the studio with alcohol in it. Not that kind of alcohol, but rubbing isopropyl. And then it's ready whenever I want it. So I just squirted a little bit on it and kind of got it everywhere. So we'll probably be using this again. Alrighty. Show you what I'm doing. Just a wild idea, and this will be in your packet. We're going to be doing some funny fish, so I will leave that right there. I don't think you can see it very good, but yep, wrong way. Let's do this bigger one first, so y'all can kind of see it. And I'm going to use I think that might work. I just sprayed one. What did I spray? There it is. I do not know if this is the one I want, but we can do a couple. Not decadent. Let's do this one. So we've got two palettes going. This one is Tropicals by Prima, and this one is Pastel Dreams. So people are all the time saying artist quality, not artist quality. Let me move this. Perfectly fine to use, so don't worry about that so much. And particularly if you can get the look that you like, go for it. It'll work fine for a journal. I wouldn't sell it, but here we go. I'm just going to use whatever this is left from. First thing I'm going to do is practice . I want to end it about right here to room for the tail. I don't know if this will show or not, but I'm going to do a little trick. See, I said about right there. Okay. Now I'm just going to drop in this greenish color. And I'm going to notice that the tail and the mouth kind of center on each other, and mine does. So I've got an outline there. Let's see, I'm going to that tail doesn't go all the way up, and I just put it there, which means that this could come a little higher. And it's more higher right there. And this nose, this mouth thing comes down. That. And we've got an eyeball right here. Or close enough. Now, I couldn't get one of these out in the wild, so forgive me. Man, I love this brush. Just getting a little bit of a drawing. Remember what color. My card is somewhere around here. The fun about this sort of painting, it's kind of like painting flowers. Nobody can criticize you because they don't know what you were looking at. The beginning, or the tail, and then I'm going to bring this tail up. And I'm going to bring it down. And I've got a little whoop-de-doo thing right there. Okay, yeah, let's have some fun. Oops, I forgot some blue up there. Doesn't really matter. And then we've got a okay. It's just easier to mark it out before you get going. And if you like to draw, then that's a good time to. Carry this on around. There's another band I missed. All right, now we need a yellow, so I'm going to go over here. And I need that blue. I just think this fish is so fun. And I think I'm going to switch back to the small Kolinsky. And I got these out. I thought they would just be so much fun for this kind of a play thing. Let's see what this does. Another special little kit of homemade paints by Pfeffer. Pfeiffer Art Supplies. And I just want some of that white. brighten that up. If I were working on white paper, that wouldn't be an issue. Use some of what's up in here. You want to guess how long this has been here? Forever. I want to bring that dark in just a little bit around that edge. And now switch back to the yellow ochre-y color. I don't know why I'm getting that. Didn't need that piece of grunge in there. Is this okay? Bright red. I don't know if that is or not. There's something. See why you don't wash out your watercolor palette? Okay, so that's that. This is the red. Gonna pull that on down and let it blend itself out. And if I need more white, I can add it. So we've got a little bit of a red. And on top of that, we have a blue. We might as well use these paints. I know everybody's got some that you were convinced that you had to have. And then I need a little bit of white. This is my fish. While this is still damp, I'm going to drop in some more. Uh-oh. See what happened there? It bled into the yellow. But on a galloping horse, nobody's going to know. And I know better than that. Y'all know I know better than that. Now, there is absolutely nothing wrong with painting from someone else's painting. Except you do not sell it as your own. Oops. We all need a little bit of fun in our lives, don't we? A little bit of white. I don't like the way that color did right there. Yeah, that's better. The thing that makes this brush so amazing is that, number one, it's handmade. And number two, the bristles are selected. Pay attention to what you're doing. And the direction that they turn is selected individually. bit of that. A little bit of blue to that green to make it blue. Getting in the ZenZone, guys. I'll put some of this fluorescent yellow on top here because I got it just a little bit bluer than what I wanted. Do the same over here. And then here. Some more yellow on top. see my tall one. Some yellow. Try not to scrub your brush. Into the paint. Well, we just keep finding more green. And that really did not have a circle on it. Doesn't matter because it's my fish. But if you want to get rid of it, just do that. Yeah, black. It's dark purple, but that will be fun. I'm gonna go all the way around this eye. And then I'm gonna put an inner circle. Wait and let that sit for a minute. And then we've got a green. another green. And we got a little green right there. These are going to be short and sweet. Now, if I wanted to, I could come back in here with a pencil or real thin. Pen. And trace the outlines. I gotta wait till that red dries a little bit, but I can do this. Q-tips come in handy. Mine are off over on the other side of the room. And that doesn't need to be there. I kind of call this freestyle watercolor, kind of like commando, because you're doing it without a drawing. And if you've ever been deep sea fishing and know what these look like, draw them from your imagination. And I need a light blue, light blue. And the center of that eye is white. Oops. See, that's why you're supposed to wait. But it's the weight. Let's see, I need a little more. Now this belly is pale yellow. And I've got one right here that has some white in it. So this comes down. And hooks in right there. And you know what? Those fins have this little color. Of course, since I have coffee dye. It's just kind of a I like the white on there a little bit better. And it's my fish. And if I want that belly to be whiter, I can just scumble. I don't have as much room for detail. This may have been done quite large. If we painted this in acrylic, we'd have a totally different look. Which I might just do that. Got my line a little bit too thick to suit me. Now I'm going to add some little highlights here and there. And there. I think he's done. So I'm going to, before I forget it, put my name on it. And there you have it. So, thanks for watching.